day, people. This is the Awareness Outreach Ministry coming back at you. It's been a little minute here. I would like to share something that happened recently. And when I wrote it up, I entitled it, The Answer to My Why Question. I had asked God, you know, why these things happen, these upsets that may happen, and familial, F-A-M-I-L-I-A-L, relations in people's lives. Particularly in Christians' lives. I'm a Christian minister, so I'm talking from that point of view. And hoping that this little talk will be some help to some and bring light to others in Jesus' name. So the title is possibly The Answer to My Why Question. Some titles that came to my mind when I was talking to God about it, actually when he began to answer me, which was like, what, a day or so later, because I was really crying out in my spirit about it, and it's something I've been dealing with for years, decades, and I got a different answer and a right answer, and as I always do from God, but maybe it's just time. It was time for me to get this answer versus the other times. That's, you'll see why I've said that later on, because you know when you got an answer from God for something that you may have been going through for a while, and we call it, you know, getting a release from God from the situation. So, I'm just going to tell you what I received in response. So some titles that came up about this was A Walk on the Dark Side. It's not just your personality. It's in a question mark. And then the question, what's going on, is the title, or a title, or the titles that were related to it. I'm a word person with God. He, you know, talks to me, tells me these things, impresses upon me these things in this way. It's all to do or coming from a prophetic anointing that's in my life. Okay. God answered my why question as it concerned a recent clash with a close encounter of a familiar kind, as I was saying, that keeps attacking me no matter what I do. My good is, hold on, should check the time. Sorry for the interruption. This situation, like I was saying, it keeps on attacking me no matter what I do. My good is evil spoken of, and I did not know what else to do as far as whether or not to keep reaching out and taking these attacks, or to go on and realize that the enemy has blocked these relations from my life by doing this, or from them being able to see the God in my life. Love can make people deaf, dumb, and blind, as we all know, and not just in some intimate relations, but for many in those natural relations, those familial relations. And just because they share blood, you know, does not mean that you are to suffer anything concerning them, but you will. You will, because of who they are. Concerning Christians, true living like believers in Christ Jesus, the ones that serve Him and Him only, you will only have fellowship with those who are also true Christians. Some people may beg to differ with some of the things I'm saying, but it's the truth anyhow. Because some other Christians may not become your friends or close with you either, which is really not of God. If they're true Christians and you're a true Christian, y'all should have a great time fellowshipping, because unity is there and oneness is there through Christ Jesus. But when it's not, when they're not true Christians, because some Christians are not close with you, and there's always a reason for it, like I said, which is not of God, it's probably your anointing that bothers them. And there's nothing you can do about that. Nothing you should want to do about it, because that's of God. That's God in you coming forth, anointing your life to be what it is supposed to be. I remember talking to God about this a long time ago as well, asking God why some Christians had this great relationship with family members and others, too. You know, they just seem to have these bouncing off the wall, happy relationships. And I remember there was a TV personality, Christian person, lady, that I knew. I knew the station, the Christian station she was on and hosted. And I met her in a Kmart store, actually. And I mean, I could not believe that God allowed me to run into her and meet her that way. And I think He did, because I had asked this question a long time ago. Why wasn't I like other Christians, you know? Because I was comparing, you know, you do this in life, in real life, whether you're Christian or not. But I was comparing my lifestyle, my ways, my behaviors and stuff, in Christ. Because, you know, you want to put your best foot forward no matter what the case is. So this is a Christian case, okay? So here I am, a young Christian in the Lord, and wanting this, and God answered it in this way. He let me meet the lady, and that I felt had all of that going on in her life. And I, you know, I brought that out to say that I'm well aware of the desires of the hearts, natural man, you know, of what we really want. And we want the best to come out of us when we meet people, when we are involved in relations, and, you know, especially among the familial relations. And you want to be received and accepted and, you know, and liked and cherished and all that good stuff, just like in an intimate relationship with a man and a woman. You want all the things that's supposed to come with that, all the good things, and you want to be your best. You want God to bring the best stuff out of you to witness to the world of Him being in your life, God being in your life. And I think I was beginning to feel at that time, this has been decades ago, but I was beginning to feel at that time that, you know, I must not be very good Christian, you know, because I didn't act that way. And the lady just was very, you know, just had this awesome personality, you know. You couldn't help but want to be, you could feel the anointing through the TV, you know, I mean, just everything that you know that happens in Christians' lives. And I wasn't there yet, you know, and I was like, you know, I wish I had that, Lord. Why can't I have that? Help me to get there, blah, blah, blah. So God helped me run into this lady, and I got a chance to meet her, and it was a blessed moment. And I went on in my life, and But I have been pursuing God. You know, I question things. You know, if you, I question God all the time. So, if what my understanding is, if I'm a part of something and my understanding is A and D is happening, I'm like, okay, something's up here and I'm going to find out what. I'm not just going to let it happen. So, you know, that's the kind of person I am. I will seek it out and get it straight, you know, because I'm not going to be a part of something and I'm not getting what it's supposed to be about. You know, it's not happening to me. So, you know, so what I'm saying is if I wanted to become a Christian and I know all these wonderful things that are supposed to happen in me, or I'm supposed to get X, Y, and Z, and I don't get the X, something's afoot here, you know? So anyway, back to my story, which that was just an example of something that had happened that's related to this. So, I remember talking to God about this a long time ago, like I said, and asked why, you know, some Christians had these great relationships with family members or familial members and others too. So they say, at least, and some I have seen the public side of, and they seem to just have great, you know, relations and all that, you know, going on, as if nobody, or as if, you know, they came into this world without sin, sort of. That's how great it seemed, you know, from my view, that's what it looked like. And I know that that's not true, because everybody came into this world with sin. And sin is on our familial relationships first, and from there on out, for the rest of our lives until Christ comes again. And so I understood that. So, you know, and when you learn that the failure to become something or not become something is not in God when you're a Christian, it's in me, it's in the person who is having the issues. Okay. So I just have this philosophy. I do look at the man in the mirror. You know, I do. My mom taught me that, you know, that when, you know, Cecilia, when something's not right, always look and see what you have done, you know, before you go pointing a finger and looking for problems, the problem in other people who's involved. So I walked in that all my life, you know, decades now. Well, the answer came to me as being the difference between callings upon people's lives and the gifts that they possess from God that are without repentance. If you are a Christian, you know the scripture that I'm talking about. The gifts and callings are without repentance. And you're going to have to look it up because I forgot to note it here. So if you have, for instance, if you have the hospitality calling, a hospitality calling, you may be seen as dripping with that feel good anointing. If you've ever experienced it, you know what I'm talking about, that many people are attracted to, and this is what most Christians would like to have, but many of us do not. Other Christians have, and some other Christians have, like a parental anointing. I can think, every time when I'm thinking about this, I'm thinking about a person or a couple or people that I've actually met in the Lord who have these anointings. Okay, so this is like a parental anointing where they care for people and people are drawn to their caring ways, like a teddy bear personality type. But it might be on a couple, you know. And it's on the whole family, you know, of these people. And you're just like, wow. And you just love those people to pieces, you know. And thank God that you're in the family of God. You have relatives like that, you know. So, because we do. When we're Christians, they belong to us as well. And we belong to them. And then some Christians have a teaching anointing where people are drawn to them because they want to learn something or or know something, or they want and need to grow in life in God through Christ. So they're drawn to people, Christians, who have a teaching anointing. And you'll know them, you know, because if that's what you're needing in life, you'll be drawn to them. Because we all have stages in life that we have to go through, and it's a process. Even in becoming a Christian, becoming and being a Christian is a process. It is a lifelong process. But you are there. You are in. Guarantee. If you are in, you're in. But if you're not, you know, then you need to make sure, you need to go back to the starting point and make sure that you at least are in the family of God. Because nothing else matters if you're not, okay? You're wasting your time. Okay, so Christians are only the same, as I was telling you before, that we have different anointings on our lives. But Christians are only the same in terms of who saved them, Jesus Christ. And who called them, Jesus Christ. And who they serve, Jesus Christ. And they're the same in the unity of the fellowship with God's family, as God's people. Okay? The rest is who we are in Christ, in our personality, giftings, etc., and anointings he gives us through the Holy Spirit to each person as he desires. You can't even pick the gifts and the callings. You can't pick the anointings that God gives you. He gives. They're gifts. Really, true gifts you don't pick. God gives them to you. Okay, every good and perfect gift, Scripture says, comes from above, comes from God. Others may have a pastoral or an evangelistic anointing to provide or to lead spiritual people in their spiritual life, or they bring good news, the message of salvation, to others as an evangelist. Then there are some who have anointings that are not so liked by others and are only a crowd pleaser when people want or need something from them. This is an anointing that people don't pick. You don't get to pick them anyway. And this is a calling that you don't pick. These callings and anointing, you don't pick these. You can't. They're given by God. So, like I said, these are people who only draw a crowd when people need something from them, like prayer or a word from the Lord, or a word that God said something's getting ready, great, fantastic, getting ready to happen, or a word of healing or deliverance or whatever, okay, in your life. And these are people that God will bring across your path when, if you are seeking him and you are in need of these things, these are the people that you will find. And I'm just saying, they're not the crowd. They're not a crowd pleaser all the time. They're not a soft drawing personality anointing all the time. Some people even find that they're very uncomfortable around these types of people. I'm just saying. And these are Christians who are prophets and prophetesses and seers, you know, in the office of these particular callings. And those, there are others as well who just have the giftings that are prophetic. The Holy Spirit may give them the gifting of healing, or the gifting of giving, or he may give them a gifting in a word of wisdom or a word of knowledge and things of that nature. So they are not actually a prophet, but they have a prophetic anointing on their lives. Now, the prophets and the seers and those of that nature, they are actually walking in that office as a prophet, you know, as a seer, as a prophetess, or of the same family. And these Christians, by their spiritual nature, are not people pleasers. They have an anointing that is all about pleasing God and upholding the righteous standard in life and delivering God's word to his people and even to the unbelievers as God leads them. They love truth, God's truth, and they are called to live it with less room for error, seemingly, compared to others, other Christians. And it's true, but that's another message for another time. They don't get to mess up a lot in life, even before they even became a Christian, actually answered the call on their life or something. God already has had his influence upon their personhood and their living. Personally, I have been called in the latter description, and I know a lot of people, but I make some people uncomfortable without saying a word, just being in the same place with me, or, you know, room with me, or whatever. But I can also be I have a personality that's very engaging and lively and sociable, or I can be a killjoy. I don't know another good word to use for some people. That's what they might would say. I haven't heard anybody say that, but I'm just trying to describe some reactions that I have encountered or haven't even said, you know, not too much, but have been said. And I, of course, have took it to God in prayer. I take everything to God in prayer because I don't have a problem receiving critique. And have no problems with being, I have no problems being a loner, this type of person with this kind of anointing, the prophet, seer type anointings. I don't have a problem being a loner or standing alone in an issue or in a place. I will stand my ground, okay? And I don't have a problem keeping to myself. Besides, I'm never alone. Really, because I'm always with God. He's always with me, you know. I'm with God, though. This type of person, like myself, loves people and can be very outgoing and generous and very caring and supportive to others. You know, a person that people will come to when they're in need. But it is also a person who is a straight arrow. I don't like messy living and relationships, and you guessed it, people who have rejected God, I don't like them, or it, or however you want to say it. I don't associate myself with that type of people, or crowd of people, or that group of people who have done so. And it's not personal, it's personal with God. So if you rejected God, then I have to reject you too, because I can't be with you. I can only be with him. I like what God likes, and I hate what God hates, period. End of story. And these things God hates. He doesn't hate the person, he hates what's in them. And until you get born again, all you have is the flesh and the devil. You know, on your best day, you can't be good enough outside of God. You can't be a good person, okay? Now, with all that said, I can find plenty of Christians who say they get along just peachy keen with their unsaved, loved one, and familial relationships. No problems. But this cannot be true. God revealed this to me today, y'all. It's not like I didn't know the scriptures, but you need a fresh rhema word from God when there's issues going on in your life that concern you. So he told me, he said, he's according to scripture, light and darkness, he just reminded me of scripture that I already know, you know, that I already know about and understand. According to scripture, light and darkness do not agree in their life walk. They live generally divided lifestyles. There's not anything you did to make it happen, per se. It's already happening. And this is according to God's word. He set it up this way. It is very possible that the Christian involved may be living in flesh. If they're getting along peachy keen, the Christian involved with unbelieving familial relationships. The Christian that's getting along with them may be living in a fleshy lifestyle, or as we call it, a worldly Christian. You know, a little bit of Christian and a whole lot of the world. And this is why they are getting along just peachy, or they are on an assignment from God. That means they have been given an anointing from God to help this person get saved. So if they're getting along with them, there's a couple of reasons why that could be. Only a couple, okay? And a true Christian can discern which is which. Usually, in these cases, in these familial cases, it is the unbelievers that don't care to have the company of the believer relations in their intimate familial circle. In the midst, many times are frictions, jealousy, envy, and hatred and strivings with no true reasons causing them to exist. Or there can be evil spirits wreaking havoc, of course, which all lead to what the Bible says about it. Division and familial relations. Because what that's talking about is Christ said, "Think not that I came to bring peace." And we'll get around to the scripture passage. Okay, so what the Bible says about it, familial relations, and past or current abusive histories also play a part with there being unhealed and wounded souls always involved in these divisive familial relations, is what I should say. I hope y'all got that. Divisive familial relations. Nobody wants this to happen in familial relations, but all people have been born into them due to the sin nature of mankind. And the only way to recover them is when the darkness turns to light, as they all become true people of God in Christ Jesus. And if they don't, then you're going to have these problems. Problems of light and darkness coming together. And there is no agreement. There can't be, according to scripture. Next, I heard what I believe is a confirmation from God today, because I cried out in prayer, like I said, "Help me, Lord. What do I do? What do I do? That will please, what should I do that will please you?" I asked him, have I truly been a bad witness to my familial ones? And what do I do from here on out, as I am a person seeking instructions from my Lord? That's me. That's my nature. That's my spirit. That's my heart. Because I'm a person of God. I need wisdom and understanding on what would Jesus do in these situations. For he is our model of righteousness before God in all relationships. The Holy Spirit told me to look at who was around Jesus. And who did Jesus spend his time most with? You know, what kind of people? And what was they about? You know, who did he spend time with? When I looked, he did not spend his time ministering and fellowshipping with his earthly familial members in his life that he was born into. Though they acknowledged him as a part of them from time to time in normal situations that occurred. However, they did not believe him or believe in him. Some did eventually later on. The Christian life brings division according to scripture, specifically among familial members who are unbelievers towards those who are the believers in those familial relationships. See Matthew 10:34, Luke 12:49-53, specifically in one's own household. Whether it's your original familiar or whether, you know, and on from there. Another prayer answer today while watching YouTube, Prophet who has a channel that I have not watched before. I did not even know Prophet, and it didn't even advertise him as a prophet. But my spirit knew him, and I seen him in passing as I was checking on other places to look at on other days.